Our first task is to load and inspect the data. We've made two text files available on the course site, and they contain the data needed in this case study. The two files are called whiskies.txt and regions.txt. The regions file contains the regions in which each of the whiskies is produced. The whiskies file contains all other details about the whiskies. Let's start by importing both NumPy and Pandas. At this point, make sure to change your working directory to match the location of the whiskies and regions files. In the text files, the entries on each row are separated by commas. This type of file is known as a comma-separated values file, or a CSV file. We'll first read whiskies into our Pandas data frame object, and we'll then read regions and add that as a column to the whisky object. We can read the CSV file using Pandas read CSV method. The file name is whiskies.txt, and I will capture this as whiskey. We'll then read the second file, and I'm going to add this into my whiskey object. I'm going to add it as an extra column, and I will call that column region. Let's take a look at these files using the head and tail methods. These are the first five rows of the data frame. Look at the last five, use the tail methods. It looks like the data has been read in correctly. We can use the ILOC method to index a data frame by location. Let's practice its use. We'll type whiskey.iloc, and we can first specify the rows. In this case, we specified the rows from 0 to 10. As with standard Python, the start index is inclusive, whereas the end index is exclusive. That means that the last row corresponding to index 10 is not included. We can use the same method to look at specific columns and specific rows. We can look at rows from 5 to 10, and we can look at columns from 0 to 5. The first 5 to 10 corresponds to rows, and the 0 to 5 corresponds to our columns. Some of the columns correspond to whiskey flavor attributes. Let's find out which ones. If we type whiskey.columns, Pandas lists us the names of the different columns of our data frame object. In this case, we would like to look at all of the columns starting from body and ending at floral, floral included. We can construct a flavors object, a flavors data frame, by looking at our whiskey object. We use the ILOC method. We specify all of the rows, and then we extract all of the columns that correspond to flavors. In this case, body is the first column that corresponds to a flavor. Its location is 2. And the last column to be included is floral. Its location is 13. But to include that in the slice, we need to specify 14 as the end of the column slice. We can now look at our flavors. And in this case, it looks like we've extracted the correct columns and rows from our table.